Joining me now is Dr. Luis Fernando Correa. He's a doctor and a medical correspondent, and he was also chief medical officer for 2014 FIFA World Cup in Brazil. He joins me from Rio de Janeiro. So, Dr. Correa, the WHO is forecasting 3 to 4 million Zika cases in the Americas. What's the mood like where you are in Rio de Janeiro? How are people coping with the fear?
Hi, Andrew. Nice to have me here. Here in Rio and in Brazil, everywhere in the country, we deal with the mosquito Aedes aegypti and the dengue virus from the last 20 to 30 years in the successive waves of infection. So we are trying to get rid of the mosquito from the last two decades, unfortunately without success. Brazil experienced it in the last 50 years a huge amount of urbanization without any kind of control. So in the big cities, in the capitals of the state especially, we have a lot of people living in conditions that's not ideal. So we don't have the garbage collection, we don't have ideal sanitation. And so it's the perfect spots for the reproduction of the mosquito. And what we need here is the change of the culture of the people. Because as you said, we cannot leave any kind of receptacle, any kind of easy-beady thing that can collect some water. We are talking about, for example, one of the plastic tabs of a soda. If something like this is open on the wild, and the mosquito puts the eggs on the sides of this small recipient, and when the rain comes, fill it the water. 1 week later, we have new mosquitoes. The numbers are against the population because one mosquito, the female mosquito that bites the people and transmit the virus, even the dengue virus, the Zika virus, or the chikungunya virus, for example, the mosquito can live for a month or something. It feeds on the humans every 3 days. So for each bite and collect blood, the mosquito creates new eggs, something like 1,000 eggs. So we are talking about one mosquito, small mosquito, biting people during a month and laying eggs in 3 days intervals, 1,000 eggs each time. So one mosquito can reproduce for 10,000 mosquitoes. So the numbers are against the population in the fight against the Aedes aegypti.
So as a doctor, I just want to ask you, so as a doctor, do you think that message is getting through that every Brazilian has to make sure that there's not one little, you know, cap that's got some water, that the 200,000 soldiers that are being deployed, I guess, to fumigate, is this battle a battle that can be won?
Andrew, I'm not sure about that. And to be real, I not believe that you can do that because the mosquito is very domestic. It's just a short flight insect. He just fly for 100 meters, 1,200 meters at maximum. So 85% of the breeding sites of the mosquito is inside of the residence or just close to the homes. So people need to take care of the backyards, of the around of even in apartments. We have the places when you put the flowers, when you put the plants in your balconies. You get rid of the small plates that people use to put behind the.
So just another question to you: what are you telling your patients? What are you telling women who want to get pregnant?
As a doctor, I need to tell them, and I'm repeating that, I'm internist, and I'm telling that to my patients, that don't get pregnant, postpone the project for at least 2 to 3 years until we know better about the Zika virus and the interaction with the human being and what could be done in terms of prevention. I don't know if a vaccine could be reached in a short time, because for dengue virus, for example, the vaccine demands almost 60 years to appear. The research starts with Sabin in 1960, and the vaccine for dengue just appeared months ago. But we have the vaccine of the yellow fever, and it's very stable. So the Zika virus, it's a virus that's close to those two different viruses, the yellow fever, that's the most stable virus, and the dengue virus, that's a very mutant virus. So We're really expecting that the Zika virus could be a stable one, and you could develop a vaccine in a short length of time. But for research, development, and especially for the approval of the regulatory agencies, it took time. Yeah. So,
well, we wish, well, we certainly, I'm sure everybody hopes that that vaccine comes sooner rather than later. But Dr. Correa, thank you very much for taking the time to speak to us today. We appreciate this. That's Dr.
Thank you for having me.
Dr. Luis Fernando Correa joining me from Rio de Janeiro.